morning, everyone. I thought I would start a new vlog. It's Monday morning. Why the hell not? It's my birthday week this week, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a weekly vlog. I've never done a weekly vlog, just done like daily vlogs, and I think actually I'll vlog little bits and bobs out of my whole week because there's not massive amounts going on at the moment and I'm just working from home and doing like the odd thing. But other than that, it's a pretty boring time. I'm just sitting here editing this vlog and are my lips all right? They look like they've had about a liter's worth of lip filler pumped through them. Do your lips swell in the morning? Is that a thing? Send help. On other news, I had an absolute skin nightmare. I had a full-on breakout and I have no idea why. I think it was maybe because of my masks I've been wearing. I don't even know, like they were all over my forehead, so I was like weird because actually my mask, I never get spots here, but that, it honestly had its own personality. It was that big. It was so big. Anyway, everyone told me to put Sudocream on it. Put Sudocream on it. I'm not joking you. It's fully dried out. Like, it's tiny now. I'm so impressed. I didn't even know the Sudocream was such a thing. My gosh, look at her. She looks extremely interesting. I'm on a walk, which I do every single morning. I do a nice walk all around the park. Sometimes I do a 20-minute HIIT workout. But mainly I walk. I mean, I was gonna run today, but she can't be bothered. I'm up. Oh, what's going on here? I'm being so, I'm pressing the wrong buttons. It's 8 a.m. and yeah, you've got to get up, get out of bed, go for that walk, go for that run, do that 20-minute HIIT workout, whatever one, get it done, do it. And then it sets me up for the day. I'm gonna go home, shower, sort myself out, and crack on with life. God, look at me. I look like I broke my neck or something. Why the hell are people out in Dubai living their best lives? Living normal life, literally like going to the salons, getting their nails done, tanning, going out into clubs, going to restaurants, having a normal life and fun. And I'm sitting here in a pile of work. Like, what? I don't understand it. I don't get it. How do I get there? I can't even go because I have to stay here and make money. I either be sensible, stay in London, make money because I'm busy over the next couple of months, or I sack it all off and go have a right laugh. What do you guys do? In case I am just having a little look on the price tag, and the flights are pretty cheap. To be honest with you, that's return. I don't think that's bad at all. Maybe I do go. I would love to, and I do think maybe like the idea is great, but then is it like a bit scary? Like, I don't know, I've got a weird thing about it. I'm like, oh, say if I get stuck there, and is it gonna be worth the money? Because maybe I won't enjoy it as much because I'd be panicking. I probably wouldn't get as much work done, let's be honest, because I'll just get drunk all the time and just be having fun, which I think I don't deserve that just yet. I need to work a bit harder and then maybe treat myself in the new year. God, I'm such an adult. What's going to me? I'm so mature. I'm surprised. I'm shocked myself. We are making
fajitas. Ole.
No, we're not.
No, chicken milanese.
Oh my god, your hair. We are basically after this, so we're making some dinner now. Chicken milanese. Chicken milanese. Anyway, you know what I mean. Chicken milanese. Oh, there we go. She got it in the end. We are doing Harvey a, see how fluffy his hair
fluffy
is.
Fluffy isn't the right word. Like, literally like frizzy.
I'm basically giving him a keratin treatment at home. I'm doing a home job, shift job. I've even bought myself this. Right, this is the before.
Look.
Show them all the fro.
Feel that.
The absolute.
Feel that through the camera.
Yeah.
It's like a hay bale meets like a dried up, I don't know, scab.
Yeah, well, that's the before.
That's why I wear a hat.
And then we'll show the after once we've done it. I hope it's good. You're going to look 10 out of 10.
I hope so. I'll need it. I'm
like
very
ugly
at the moment.
Oh, don't be down on yourself. I think everyone feels ugly at the moment. I certainly do. Have you seen this? Ready?
I'm butters.
I'm vile. Is this even on me?
Oh, wow. That's, yeah. Yeah, not great lighting there.
Oh.
Well, no.
What can you do? Everyone's feeling the same.
Lockdown butters syndrome, it's called.
We're not feeling great, but this is why we need to make ourselves feel great.
Lockdown butter syndrome is in full swing.
That's why we're going to tuck into a load of pasta. Hi guys, welcome to Emily's salon. Oh, wow. Sorry, my skin is playing one cruel, cruel trick on me at the moment. So I've got the spot cream at the ready. About to start the hair.
Thank
God knows what we're doing.
I'm going to have to walk you through this. But basically we're turning the toilet brush into a malleable and hopefully nice set of hair. Okay. Interesting.
Don't put loads in, I reckon that'll be enough.
Well, I haven't got much hair, have
I? Oh, it stinks.
Whoa.
Oh my God, that stinks.
Emily, relax. It's
no,
not that bad.
That is gross.
I mean, it'll get you high, but it's not that bad. Whoa. Doesn't smell too bad. Oh, that's why my hair smells after I do this treatment.
Yeah, it stinks.
Okay, right. And you got your brush.
Got my salon brush.
Why is that thing so long and pointy? What's the point of that?
Because you go like this. Separate things.
Wear suitable gloves, Emily.
I haven't got any gloves.
Right, again.
We're going in bareback.
Divide hair into four sections. As for a colour service.
Oh, shame.
You know what that is?
No, that's for when you do hair.
It says start at the nape. N-A-P-E. What the hell's the nape?
What's the nape? Shall I ask my mum?
Does that mean the, like, parting?
I
reckon. Which I think is like here. And then they normally start from like that bit and then kind of brush it in. And then it just, what it says, this is the main bit to avoid contact with the scalp. So you want to basically be 1 centimeter off the root.
You've been using my nice shampoo. I told you not to use that.
Yeah,
I can smell it in your hair.
Emily, this is all part of the process.
Okay, right, here we go.
I mean, I would just fucking whack
fucking
it on
nothingly.
My head, to be honest. It's like painting, but you just need to get around all the part of the hair, like four walls. Each hair has four.
I can't believe how funny it smells. Poor. Guys, if only you could smell this. This is chemical. I feel like I've been breaking bad.
Breaking bad hair. That's what you're doing.
What, and then once I've brushed it in, we comb it?
Oh, it's actually, it does stink. The other ones I've done don't stink like this.
So we have painted it all on. Now he's got...
I'll sit here and read the instructions for 30 minutes.
Honestly, guys, hit me up if anyone wants keratin treatment.
Christ, it's not a good look.
I don't think I'll suit bold.
Look at that. Egghead boy.
I mean, I think we've got the wrong thing, Em. Straightening cream as opposed to keratin.
It's the same. It all just.
I look like a god.
You look like a punk rocker, mate.
State of this, and it's like it's definitely softer, but I've had keratin before and it doesn't just make it like straight like that, it just softens the hair.
Oh. Well, it's better than the fro, so
Houston, we have a serious problem. There is a big difference between straightening cream and a keratin treatment. So keratin treatment results in silky smooth hair, which gradually fades after a few months. A keratin treatment is unlike the straightening process. A keratin treatment is more about manageable, smooth, frizz-free hair. This is what I've done in the past. Unless about stick straight, unnatural looking hair. What, this makes my hair like dead straight. It's like stuck straight. That's the, as opposed to just more soft and manageable. So you had a conversation with this guy on the phone and said, do you have the keratin treatment in stock? And he said, what did you?
My hairdresser sent me a picture of the one that she would get if she was to do your hair from the wholesalers.
Yeah, that was keratin. It said something keratin.
Yeah, and then I rang him and he said, we don't have that in stock anymore. I said, do you have anything that does the same thing? He said, yeah, this thing here.
Permanent straightening makes your hair straight. It is not as flat. It is not as flat as hair that has been ironed, but it dries as though you had naturally straight hair. And I'm gonna look so stupid with naturally straight hair. This is permanent.
No, it's not.
It is.
The box. Where's the box?
This is permanent straightening.
You might love this.
I'm gonna look like a nerd. Look at the state of me.
I think you look handsome.
I've got a pedo mustache, straight
this,
hair.
Yeah, this.
I'm pale as dick.
This is the final product.
Well, which, unstyled product, but if you
I really like
look
it.
Closely, look how much
it's so
like softer it is and like floppy compared to how it was before.
Once you get a bit of gel in that,
but actually it would actually blow in the wind for once.
Good morning everyone, it's actually my birthday. I'm the big 25. She can't believe it. I've actually made it to 25. I feel like this is a pinnacle moment for me. You know, it's a big birthday, 25. I can't work out if I'm gonna have a mental breakdown or not, because I do feel like I need to get my shit together. You know, my mum had 2 kids by now and a house. What have I got? None of that. But it's fine, we'll get there, everyone. Harv's currently making me pancakes, which is so sweet. He was like, do you want pancakes for breakfast? I love breakfast, but I love it. So he's going to get me pancakes and make me a coffee. And I'm going to go for a nice walk with my friend Mariella, who lives next door. And she lives on her own, so we're kind of in like a bit of a bubble because she lives on her own. And Harv said he's got a few things planned, but God knows, because we're in lockdown, so. I'm excited.
Onion strawberries.
Onion strawberries?
Honey and strawberries.
Oh, there's no bananas. Thanks, Harv.
If you birthday mean.
It's my birthday mean. Oh, this looks nice.
Prezi time. Here we go. This one first.
Okay.
And then these two.
Is this Christmas shopping?
Well, there was only, that was all there was in lockdown, I'm afraid. I had to make do. An avocado! That's nice. What?
Why are you giving me avocado?
Just for you like avo on toast, so I thought you liked that one. Smashed avo, it's versatile, you can get all sorts.
Jewelry.
What's a sock, man? You love sockies. It's because that one's the one you keep leaving around. You kept leaving it in the dining rooms. I thought you'd want it back as a present. You lost it, man. No, this one's for real. Sorry.
But this is my jewelry box.
No, it's not. Some sour cream and chive dip, me. That's it.
Oh.
Happy birthday, you're the best.
Thank you so much for my presents. Yeah. Don't worry, he's brought in the real ones.
Right, round two, the real opening.
Oh my God, this is the best present ever.
I've wanted
one of these for so- Is this like a really high?
I'm not sure this is the best idea I bought you that. What's the lucky voice? The ones that are in Soho. You just plug it into like TV and then you've got like the karaoke
Like you can link to all the songs they have.
I can't wait. This is the best thing in the whole
entire world. For your friend.
Are these more mics?
Yeah, one more, mate. You need two, don't you?
Oh my god, that's the best thing ever. So I just got back from my walk and I walked in and this was all set up. You're very sweet, aren't you? Very, very sweet.
Trying my best.
How nice are all these colours? Literally, this is just the ultimate lockdown party. We're gonna have this, karaoke. It's gonna be the best day
this
ever.
Is
no. And I got a little delivery from Estee Lauder. They've given me some really nice perfume. This, which I wear all the time. They've got my colour, which I use, Tawny. And this is really, really great. I love this. And all my favourite bits with my initial on, which I just love an initialed thing. People who did the balloons, bless them, they've given me a little bday treat of some alcohol, which I'll be tucking into. Got some bits from the Avenue. Oh, we're having a right little party up in here. I'm actually having the nicest day ever. Thanks,
Sam. Show me that for Sam.
Oh, yeah. And Harvey, he didn't just get me an avocado and salt. He got me. I don't know. Let me see if you can see it. A really nice necklace. He got me, I'm gonna get ready in a minute. He got me some UGG slippers, which I wanted. What else did you get? Oh, a karaoke machine, the best. And also a ring as well to match my necklace, but it's a bit big for me, so
I'm gonna
get it. And oh, and my jewelry box, put my jewelry in, because I have all the little individual boxes. What a darling. Honestly, I don't know what's going on this year, but I'm just feeling the love. I really need to start getting way better at other people's birthdays because people have been unreal for mine. Look at these dry flowers that I got from Nasty Girl. Is it Nasty Girl? Nasty Girl? God knows. Look. Oh my God. Oh, I got a bottle of champagne. Oh, we've just had our neon sign delivered, which we've been waiting for ages. How cool does that look? Like, fully lights up the room. Where's this from, Harv?
You turn neon.
Oh, you turn neon. Oh my God, that's so clever. Having some technical issues. So this is day two of birthday celebrations. Look how lovely my necklaces are, Harvey bought me. So I'm just sitting here, got a little glass of red because it's my birthday. And I do feel like, okay, it was my birthday yesterday, but obviously you do have more than one day, don't you, celebrating? Like, especially mine landed on a Friday, so technically this whole weekend is my birthday. And Harvey knows full well that we're having a good few days of, I don't know who I think I am. Do I think I'm the queen or something? I'm not joking you. I've had the nicest birthday I think I've had in a long time. I have no idea. I've just had the best time. So people out there, if you're worried about having a birthday in lockdown, don't panic because I've had a lovely, lovely time. Look at this lovely little setup. Look, I'm watching The Holiday. Got my candles on. Got my new sign. Oh, might even get on the karaoke later with Harv. And Harvey, he's just popped out, he's on his way back now to cook me dinner. He's making me this. How sweet is he honestly? He is actual goals sometimes. Sometimes he's annoying, but a lot of the time he is goals. Got this delivered, which is from xoxox, which is like a homemade, really premium steak thing that they send you from the restaurant. Look how amazing that is. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Steak is like one of my favorite meals. But how cute, he was like, Em, I'm gonna make you dinner, like I'm cooking it for you. I know it's your favorite. Like I had no idea he had planned all of this. So yesterday we literally had just the nicest day, just chilling out. We actually, me and Harv had our own little frat party. So we dressed up and like played beer pong and stuff. We're so sad, but it was actually really, really fun. So yeah, we got red cups, we played beer pong. It was really good. Like we dressed up in American clothes. You can tell that 2020's really, really got to us, hasn't it? There are my balloons. They're still up, looking gorgy gorge. Gorgy gorge. Oh, did I just say that? I'm horrid.
Forever.
Oh my gosh, this looks...
Bang bang, right?
I'm absolutely loving working from home at the moment. I mean, I don't think I've left my house in about 48 hours, which I think is completely normal. Although, I've done my hair, I've had a shower, but I have put my pajamas back on. I've got my slippers on, got my candles on the go. My nan sent me some shortbreads, which is like a musical tin, and it makes a noise when you put the top on. My heart has melted. To go with my cup of tea, because she knows that I love biscuits and tea. I might start crying in a minute. I actually really miss my nan and granddad. I've not seen them in so long. This is coming to the end. Well, this is going to be the end of my birthday vlog. I mean, I hope you guys have enjoyed it. My next video is going to be another haul. So I will get that out as soon as possible because I feel like I've not done a haul in a while. So I think it's going to be, yeah, I won't tell you what it's going to be because I'll leave that surprise, bit of suspense. But yeah, please like, subscribe, let me know like what else you want to see. I know I say that every single time, but you guys do give me ideas. So continue with that because I need ideas. Big love.